What is good YouTube? My name is Samir Ross and welcome to the Marshall Consulting Channel. In today's video we're going to talk about goals and specifically about how you can achieve your goals as a dojo owner or as a martial arts school owner. Let's straight up get started. So first of all, most people in this world are bad with setting goals. Or there are 99% of people, let's be honest here, set goals but they never reach their goals. So they say, for example, I want to make 10,000 euros per month or dollars or pounds, whatever, per month with my business, whatever. I just want to make that money for whatever reason. Or I want to have this car or whatever it might be. And then they just go about life and don't take any action on it. Now for you as a martial arts school owner, it's probably different because you're having your goal and you're here and you want to get to your goal. And as we've already talked about in the previous videos, you need to walk through basically fire in order to get there, through a bitch of fire to get together. Like, you need to walk through the pain every day and you need to accept the pain every day and go through the pain every day in order to get to your goal, which is obvious, hopefully for you already. If not, watch our previous videos about this. Don't watch them, I don't care. And basically you already have the business, like the vehicle that brings you to the point. Like, let's say you're at 5k per month and you want to reach 20k per month. Like, you have the vehicle already that brings you there, which most people lack already. But still, like, let's say for example you want to get from 5k per month to 20k per month in 3 months. Why in 3 months? Because let's say you're not there in 3 months and you're then only at like 12k per month. Dude, you've made like plus 7k in like 3 months, but you're not at 20k per month. So your brain is going to be like, fuck, we didn't do what we said we were going to do. So you're kind of just fucking your belief system over, if we can say it like this. The thing is that this is like what happens to 99% of people. Like, most people are fucking bad with goal setting and then especially with setting like a time frame for reaching their goals. Like, you have to be extremely, extremely pessimistic with when you want to reach your goals. And like the best thing to do, which is I also personally try to implement this right now all the time, is like, just remove the time frame. So you're at 5k per month right now with your dojo and you want to get to 20k per month with your dojo. All right, easy. You just do everything the best. You just give it your best every day to get to 20k per month. And you just do that every day. And then you just don't have a time frame when you want to get there. You just want to get there. Or let's say you want to hire a really good instructor. You're not saying, oh, I want to hire a good instructor by May and it's March right now. You're just saying, oh, I want to hire a really good instructor. And then you're giving it your best every day. And then you just remove the time frame and say, I want to hire a really good instructor. And then it might take like 1 year. It might only take a month. You don't know. But just remove the time frame from your goals. So now that we have this out of the way, let's talk about how you can actually achieve your goals. Like, how? Like, what do you have to do? Like, how do you achieve your goals? Now, this depends on your martial arts school and on how you run your martial arts school, etc. But you basically just want to reverse engineer your goals. So let's say the goal is 20k per month, then you just write down, all right, this is what I would have to need to be at 20k per month. And then you just reverse engineer it. So you have basically mapped out for every single day what you need to do today in order to be at 20k per month. It's basically pretty straightforward. I mean, the more in depth you can do this, the better it is. But the most important thing is it takes some time to do so. Like, it really takes some time to really figure this stuff out and to really be like, all right, what do I need to do today in order to be at 20k per month? But it's also more importantly, like, with the more detail you can do this, and this is probably why it takes so much time, with the more detail you can do this, like, you could figure out how your dojo would look like at 20k per month, what you need to do every day, the faster you'll be there, firstly, but the more time it will take to maybe create this document, because you would write it down, would be pretty good. But as I've said, it depends a lot on kind of how you run your dojo. So I can't really talk about that too much right now. So the next thing we have to talk about is, why do you want to reach your goal? Which is something that is super overlooked by people. Because, okay, I can tell you one thing, like, straight up. If you're at 2k per month right now and you want to get to 20k per month, it's obvious why you want to get there. You're at 2k per month, you want to provide for your family. There is like a specific reason for why you want to get to 20k per month. But it's like, or to 10k per month, 50k, you just want more money basically because you want to provide for your family or because you just want to pay the bills every month without thinking about money. Like, you don't want to worry about money. But I think there's like a study, once you make like 80k per year or something like that, or more like this, it doesn't really matter how much you make. So once you're with your dojo at like 10k per month and all of your financial things are kind of okay, like your family's doing well, you're doing well, you're not having to worry about money, or you're not having to think about money every day, you basically need a reason for why you're going to move forward. So write that down. Ask yourself, why do I want to get to 100k per month? And then write that down. But also do this when you're at 2k per month and you want to get to 10k per month. Like, just write down why you want to get to 10k per month. I know it's obvious because you want to, maybe you even want to buy a specific car, whatever it might be. But just write it down. And then something that will come out, which is pretty common, is something like, as a kid, all of the kids around me were super productive and I wasn't. Which was, for me, for example, the case when I did this exercise for my company. Now I'm in a completely different industry, although not different industry, but I have a different business model than you guys. But still, it's something that will probably come out. Or it's something like, I got bullied when I was like 12. And now I want to build this dojo and I want to achieve financial freedom or whatever it might be. I think it's simple and straightforward to do. Just sit down and like ask why. Like, why do I want to achieve? Why do I want to buy this car, for example? Because I want attention from... I want attention. And why do I want attention? Well, because I like when other people see me. And then you just ask why until you can't answer why anymore. And this might take you like an hour, so don't be surprised. And don't be surprised if your ego is against the answers that are coming up there. But it's super helpful too. And then lastly, we have, where do you want to reach your goal? Like, what is the environment like? Straightforward, or like, basically it depends on your situation, how your dojo is doing, but like, keep your dojo clean, have everything simple for your dojo, don't overcomplicate things. Probably depends more on your situation, how your dojos kind of line up. But yeah, that's basically how you reach your goals as a dojo owner. It's simple and straightforward, and I hope this video was helpful to you. If so, please leave a like and subscribe. Also, if you're owning a dojo already, click the first link in the description. It's the funnel, which is designed to sell you something. Besides that, I'll see you in the next one. Take care.